Thank you, Eric, for inviting me to talk in this master series of microsurgery for residents. Today, I'm going to talk about different microsurgical approach for lymphedema. Disclosure. The goal of treatment of lymphedema definitely is improve quality of life, limiting patient morbidity and improving functionality. Indications, surgical treatment of lymphedema should be done after 6 months of fail in conservative treatment. Also, if patients has a lot of pains, there is a problem with the function of the affected limb, recurrent infection, lymphosarcoma, or if patients don't want to improve the cosmetic appearance. Surgical treatment option, I divide it in physiological and excisional procedures. Physiological procedures are LVA or vascular lymph node transfer are the most common physiological procedures. The LVA, the aim of the LVA is just to bypass the lymph into the venous system. There are probably hundreds of papers talking about LVA. However, LVA have demonstrated that it is an important procedure to reduce limb volume and episodes infection of the affected limb. And definitely works better for in early stage. And there is few complications reported with this technique. Definitely to have a very success for in an LVA, we need to identify a suitable lymphatic vessel to be compatible with the vein. Also, we need to see and there is a minimal reflux in the after the anastomosis. Anastomosis of the lymphovenous bypass can be done by hand or by Coppler. There are many types of LVA described in literature. However, we can predict intraoperative the outcome of an LVA, looking the size, the translucence, if there is a sclerosis or if there is backflow from the lymphatic vessels. Also, we can see if there is a lot of fat or fibrosis in the surrounding tissue. So which patients are ideal for LVA? Definitely patients who has a linear pattern or a sparse blood pattern will have better result after LVA because quality of lymphatic vessels in early or advanced stage are very different. This we can predict in the preoperative ICG. Lymphography. Also, we need to remember that we can one patient have different patterns in the affected limb. Also, it is very important to do ICG lymphography to see where can we place the LVA. We need to remember that as lymphedema and lymphosclerosis progress, the efficacy of LVA may decrease. I'm selecting very meticulous when I should do LVA. This is some result of LVA preoperative and postoperative. On an early stage, here there is some cases of advanced stage after a pre-post LVA. However, there is still some controversies in LVA surgery. When is the best time to do an LVA, how many LV days has been done in one patient with lymphedema, or where we need to do the LVA. Remember, in vascular lymph node transfer, the concept is just to transfer lymph nodes into the affected lymph to restore the lymphatic drainage function. There are several lymph node flaps described in the literature, and new options have been proposed. Also, proximal, medial, and distal have described as recipient file of vascular lymph node transfer. Regarding the growing lymph node transfer, is the most common usage of lymph node described in the literature. We need to avoid harvesting sentinel lymph node to avoid iatrogenic lymphedema. This is a patient with inguinal lymph node transfer to the distal upper limb. Here, a patient with the inguinal vascular lymph node transfer to the distal limb. We have also used and reports in a series of cases the use of supraclavicular lymph node transfer that is based in the transversal cervical vessels. We can harvest this flap with or without the skin. We got good clinical and also lymphocytography results postoperative. But in 2014, we look another option for lymph node transfer, and we look into the abdomen who has more than 200 lymph nodes. So that's why we start to use different intra-abdominal lymph node flaps described in the literature. Nowadays, we are using the gastroepiploic lymph node flap. This flap is based in the right gastroepiploic vessels, lymphatic tissue, and lymph nodes. Here we can see the design around the Grecher curvature, and this flap is rich in lymphatic tissue and lymph nodes. We have described this in an open laparoscopic and also robotic techniques. We insert the flaps always in dependent position. We got satisfactory results with minimal donor site morbidity. Here we can see the CT scan at 5 months post-op showing 3 lymph nodes after gastroepiploic lymph node transfer. Here a picture of 17 post-op. We can see the results. This is a lymphoscintigraphy of one patient that we can see here, the lymph node transfer and the improvement of the lymphatic function after vascular lymph node transfer. We report the use of this flap with 2 levels of insert. Here, after flap harvest, flap is divided in 2 on-site table and then transferring in 2 different levels of the affected limb. ICG can be used to visualize so the lymphatics and also the vascularity of the transferred flap. Here are some results. So we can see this picture showing 2 levels of inserts and is resulting upper and also lower extremity lymphedema. We can see the lymphoscintigraphy, how much improvement at the proximal part has the patient has after vascular lymph node transfer. And when we compare results single versus double level insert, we found that there is only a statistical significance difference using 2 flaps at proximal region. Advantage of using this flap is minimal donor site morbidity and no causing iatrogenic lymphedema after flap harvest. Also, we can use this flap in bilateral cases, and we have done some cases using 3 kinds of inserts to get a uniform reduction rate in all the limb. Disadvantages that need expert laparoscopic surgeons and also flap preparation and anastomosis will increase the operating time. We have also found another options such as appendicular lymph node transfer for the treatment of lymphedema. We can see here this patient after 6 months post-op the improvement of the lymphatic drainage. Here also we have described the ileocecal lymph node flap based in the ileocolic artery and vein in its lymph nodes and lymphatic tissue. Here the results in one patient, stage 2 ISL, 15 plus months of follow-up. Indication should be performing in very selected patients and when the most common lymph node flaps are not available to harvest. In this study, when we compare the long-term clinical outcome with different vascular lymph node transfer with patients with stage 2, stage 3 ISL, in 83 patients, we have used the lymph node flaps like the groin, supraclavicular, gastroepiploic, ileocecal, and appendicular. We found that there is only a statistical significance difference when we compare stage 2 and stage 3. And then there is no difference between flaps. We found that there is all flaps reduce episodes of infection pre and post-operative. One interesting thing that we found in this study is that only 46% of patients show the transfer lymph node flap in a post-operative lymphoscintigraphy. In some patients, even they have improvement in the lymphatic drainage, they don't show the lymph node flap transfer. In this study, we did three patients report no improvement or symptoms. In this study that we compare donor site morbidity after vascular lymph node transfer with the most common flap used in our unit, we got hematoma, lymphatic leak, and seroma as complications. This patient post supraclavicular lymph node flap got lymphatic leak. However, we managed conservative and no donor site lymphedema has been reported 2 years post-op. During the growing lymph node flap harvest in this patient, we have leak. We managed also conservative and no donor site lymphedema has been reported by lymphoscintigraphy. We share some technical tricks to avoid complications during some flaps. The growing lymph node transfer is based in the SCIA, medial branch of the femoral artery, the superficial inferior epigastric artery, or just the reverse flow of the SCIA. When the SCIA is very small, we include a small cuff from the femoral artery to improve the patency rate of the anastomosis. Then the femoral artery is repaired by Prolin 5-0. Also, we have used the distal SCIA in the reverse flow when the lymph nodes are very close to the origin. Donor site scar is well hidden by the close. Another lymph node flap described in the literature is the submental lymph node flap. However, this flap should be harvested very meticulous in order to don't damage the marginal mandibular nerve. Regarding the supraclavicular lymph node flap, is based in the transverse cervical vessels. We need to be very careful to do the dissection of the pedicle and connected the pedicle with the flap. This flap can be harvested with or without skin. Here, sometimes the skin is not reliable. That's why we are harvesting this flap without a skin island. Always we try to do two vein anastomosis to improve the lymphatic drainage and to avoid venous congestion. We recommend to harvest flap from the right side to avoid potential injury to the thoracic duct. Scar is always well hidden. Regarding the gastroepiploid lymph node flap, based in gastroepiploid vessels, we try to avoid go proximal to the pancreas to avoid pancreatitis. Unfortunately, we didn't find donor site morbidity clinically and by CT scan. In a study where we compare outcomes of patients with upper or lower extremity lymphedema treated with different lymph node transfer, we found that lymph node transfer works better in upper extremity cases. Here, ICG lymphography is used to see the lymphatics and the vascularity of the lymph node flap. Some people just combine the LBA with vascular lymph node transfer also. This is always or sometimes criticized due to the bulky of the flap, especially when it's transferred to the distal limb. However, we did a microsurgical debarking procedure. We report this technique, how to improve the cosmetic appearance of the transferred flap. Here, picture shows where lymphatic is preserved during the debulking. Lymph nodes also is preserved during the debulking, and we can see the difference between the immediately post-op of the vascular lymph node transfer and after microsurgical debulking procedure. In the same study, we found that 21% of 83 patients stage 3 underwent excisional procedure. So we combine excisional procedure with physiological procedure. This we combine, for example, liposuction and vascular lymph node transfer. Here we combine the basal technology with LBA. ICG is used preoperative to identify if there is suitable lymphatic vessel available distally. And distally, we perform 2 or 3 anastomoses. Basal technology can be done using 25 minutes in average of the affected limb in combination with later the LVA. This technology has been done in secondary cases. Here some results of secondary. This is primary cases. And this primary lymphedema has been treated with this technique, and we can see how is the lymphatic drainage improvement of both lymph. However, when there is a lot of dermal fibrosis, there is a very strong fibrotic component, and when there is liposuction in a suitable procedure for some kind of patients, we are combining a radical reduction preserving perforators with vascular lymph node transfer. RRPP is an excisional procedure that combines the excisional procedure with the microsurgical sinking. So we preserve perforators in this kind of procedure. This is a patient pre-op. Here we can see intraoperative picture showing the perforators and also the lymph node flaps. Here some pictures and some results in the upper extremity cases, here in lower extremity cases. So we combine vascular lymph node transfer to restore the lymphatic drainage after the excisional procedure. We combine this because we want to resect all the fibrotic and the skin component. Also, we are applying the same concept of RRPP with LVA here. So the large incision, we can easily identify suitable, if there is suitable lymphatic vessels to do LVA in combination with this kind of excisional procedure here, the pre and the postoperative pictures. In advanced stage, we have described the Chahova procedure that is a combination of Charles Hoffman and vascular lymph node transfer. These are the marking for the Charles and Hoffman procedure. And lymph node transfer has been done and transferred to the distal part of the lymph. Intraoperative picture showing the procedure at the end of the surgery. All patients have dramatic change in the circumference reduction rate. Why we combine vascular lymph node transfer? Because we want to decrease episodes of infection and improve the lymphatic drainage of the affected foot. Should be indicated only in advanced stage on when patients have recurrent cellulitis or osteomyelitis of the toes. These are some examples of the Chahova procedure in patients with advanced stage of genital and lower extremity lymphedema. In this case, for example, we have done and we have resected 47 kilograms of lymphedematosus tissue, improving quality of life of patients. Nowadays, I'm combining surgical treatment in breast cancer relative lymphedema patients. In 2014, Vitanen et al. Described the combination of the TIEP with the growing flap to treat this kind of patients. Also, Jaume Masia described his total breast anatomy restoration for this kind of patients. And now we are using the simultaneous gastroepiploid vascular lymph node transfer and DFLAP for microvascular breast reconstruction and lymphedema reconstruction. Here, for example, is a video showing the marking of the DF and the gastroepiploid. The DFLAP is harvested, and then through the laparotomy incision, we go to the gastroepiploid lymph node flap intraabdominally, and then these flaps will be transferred to, in this case, is transferred to the axilla. This is an alternative approach to the previous described technique. The advantage is that you can place the lymph node flap in different locations than the axilla. You can control the DIP and you can use bilevel lymph node transfer. And the most important, there is no risk of iatrogenic lymphedema. In addition, you can use the ICG technology to visualize the lymph nodes and lymphatic flap. So here there is some patients pre and post-operative after simultaneous breast and lymphatic reconstruction using the gastroepiploid lymph node transfer and the DF flap. In summary, LBA and vascular lymph node transfer should be done for early stage. In our hands, gastroepiploid vascular lymph node transfer is a safe approach for the treatment of lymphedema and avoid iatrogenic lymphedema. If we want to choose an excisional procedure, liposuction is our first choice for advanced stage. Combined excisional and physiological procedures should be performed in advanced stage in order to treat physiopathologically the fluid and the solid component of a lymphedema patients. Also, in patients who require breast and lymphedema reconstruction, these patients can be treated simultaneously using the DF flap with the gastroepiploid lymph node transfer. In conclusion, in lymphedema treatment, adequate patient selection is the key to success in lymphedema microsurgical treatment. With, of course, there are many procedures in lymphatic surgery, will be also many controversies. Just want to finish this. If you want different results for your patients, don't try to do the same things. Thank you very much.